Okay, working on cleaning the wheels today on the new 5x10 trailer. Got a used trailer. I'm going to make it into a new one. And I'm going to sand the wheels down and put a coat of paint on. So I did half of it, so it doesn't take too long for the video. And you have more time for other stuff. All right, so let's get the camera down here on the wheel. I've already done this side here. It has a little bit more work to do on it, not much. Get you some 80 grit paper. I have some 50 and some 80. You can see there, 80 and 150. So I'll start with the 80 grit too. And I got my air conditioner running. I just turned it on. You can see I was sweating a little bit. So I'm going to start with 80 grit. We're going to knock it down real quick. And a lot of this rust is just from the lug nuts. We're rusting and dripping rust all over the wheel and staining it. I love doing that now. I'm getting this back edge right here. I'm gonna spin the wheel around so you can get a look at the side we're working on so you're not trying to see that in there. And then once on the inside of these, you want to maybe take that and curve it a little bit. Work it like that in the corners. Providing that's the kind of wheel that you have. You might want to go ahead and get all those first. That way when you get closer to the finish line, you don't just forget paint over a dirty and unclean wheel as far as. So I already did one of these wheels that took me, including doing the back and painting it, about 30 minutes. And it was about this dirty. I was looking for a video on cleaning up some old wheels, being these wheels, and I couldn't find a piece of video on it. So I'm going to make a video, and I don't know whether it'll be a decent video, but so far it worked for me. So maybe this will help you a little bit. This is not an instant gratification kind of thing, but that's something you gotta, well, you don't have to. You can leave your wheel rusty and go with the wet run look, which that kind of cool too. But I want it a little bit, just a little bit polished, but a little bit antique looking. I'm not going to do this on all three of the wheels for you guys. I'm just going to do this one only so we can move on to the more fun of building a teardrop. And that's cutting the wood, running the wires, doing a little bit of bondo, a little bit of fiberglass. Pretty close. Good. Like I said, most of this stuff is just stained from the rusty lug nuts that were on here. You go through the stain, and you go through the paint, and you see the metal. But that's okay. The paint that I bought is for, it says for direct metal without, you don't have to go and put a primer on it as well. I'm only going to need these wheels to look good for me for a little while. Backing this up. My plan is to buy some wheels off the internet that match my new F-150 and put those on here. Maybe somebody has some takeoffs that they wanted to put mags on their truck or something. I'll probably end up taking these out to my farm and using them on the farm trailers out there. Tape it if you don't want to, but yeah, it's a little better if you do. You can use a regular masking tape. I'm just using this blue tape because it's what I had. Back already hurts and I haven't done anything. Okay. Let's get that going. Let's go one more time around. If you have access to a friend's got a sandblaster, that would be the way to go. You sandblast it so much better. But One thing you want to do is make sure you spray directly at a 90 degree into that crack all the way around. Otherwise you'll have a white spot. You tilt this a little bit like that and scooch all over here a little bit like this. And this has already been pretty shaking. I'm going to bend them, bounce them over a little bit. Okay, I'm gonna, really don't want to breathe that, so I'm gonna get my respirator on. I'm starting to smell it. I really don't want to breathe it, but that'll pretty much conclude the narration part of it.
Well, I take my mask off again. Woohoo!
I'm saying earthquake. All right, that's today's work on the 5x8 teardrop camper. I haven't decided on a name for it yet, but we'll figure one out.